NOCK's head of Team Kenya to Rio Olympics, Stephen Soi, who was also charged for theft and abuse of office, did not appear in court but was represented by his lawyer Joel Bosek, who clarified to the prosecution that his client was sick and admitted to Nairobi Hospital. The prosecution demanded an immediate admission verification documents from Soi's lawyer, who promised to present them on Monday. Lady Justice Charity Oluoch ruled out the accused will not be able to conduct any witnesses, nor should they appear in any court premises without authorization, as police intensified the investigations. Moreover, the accused will be required to provide the court with their passports and will not be allowed to move out of the country until 21 days of investigations are over. Both Ochieng and Kanyili will appear before the prosecution on the 19th of next month, while Soi is expected to appear for mentioning this Wednesday. 2 days ago, Sports Cabinet Secretary Dr. Hassan Wario disbanded NOCK. Meanwhile, a section of Northeastern MPs have defended the Sports Secretary's position, arguing that the Rio fiasco squarely lied with the NOCK. Led by Moyale Member of Parliament Robert Duba, the MPs say Wario did his part by disbanding NOCK.
Something goes wrong within your docket, and you act, and in this case, the disbandment of the by CS Wario on NOCK. For me, that's fair enough. Where the problem will come, and the bucket will say that will stop at the boss, is where something has gone wrong under your watch.
Meanwhile, Kenya will seek the help of the International Olympic Committee, IOC, in reconstituting a credible National Olympic Committee following the disbandment of the disgraced group after the Rio Olympic Games debacle. Announcing the measures that the ministry will undertake in revamping the disgraced committee, Sports Cabinet Secretary Dr. Hassan Wario, who spoke after meeting various sports association officials at Kasarani Stadium, also released a revised list of the 8-member committee that is tasked with probing the selection of athletes, provision of kits, and composition of the list of the traveling contingent to the just-ended Olympic Games in Brazil.
We are going to strengthen the Anti-Doping Agency of Kenya. We're going to work closely with all the major federations that are on the front line to ensure Kenyan athletes continue participating, competing clean. You don't have to win. Winning is, you know, winning and losing is part of the game, but participate when you're clean.
The probe team, which will be chaired by Paul Ochieng, is expected to table its findings in 30 days. Sports Kenya chairman Fred Muteti, whose board took over the activities of NOCK, added that they will initiate a process of reviewing the constitution of the Olympic Committee.
Our proposal as Sports Kenya is that now that the elections of NOCK are around the corner, we need to support our minister in the action he took of disbanding NOCK.